There are a lot of uses for PI performance equations, but one of the truly nice uses is the ability to build active points or trigger tags. I'm going to go into my SMT, System Management Tools, and click on Performance Equations. And I want to show you a couple different examples of triggers. The first example is going to simply be where a tag level or a tag value goes over a certain set value. In this case, I'm going to use a temperature tag, and I want to define my batch start when the temperature goes over an ambient temperature. And let's say the ambient temperature is 80 degrees. So I'm going to just call this trigger one, and it's actually going to be an integer is the result of the equation. So I'll call this an int 16. And the point source is already filled out. My point source is already pointing to my performance equation engine. So that's all set. I can click on the equation tag here. And my equation is simply going to be CDT 158 is greater than 80. That's a temperature tag. Now, if I hit the evaluate button here, I'm going to get an error because I need to pay attention to the specific performance equation syntaxes. And the syntaxes, if you need a really quick rule to remember, is tag name and timestamp in single quotes, strings in double quotes. And you can see here that I clearly have a tag name, so I can put single quotes around it, click evaluate, and you can see that this does evaluate to true. This expression is true. If it were currently false, let's say over 800, then it would evaluate to zero. So I have an expression that I've created to validate, to tell me whether this tag is over a certain level. Now, the only other thing we need to really pay attention to here is the scheduling. Do I want to schedule it based on a clock? And this would be the scan classes that are part of the performance equation interface. Or do I want to do event-based scheduling? And what I think I'll do is I'll base the event on that tag itself. So CDT 158, I could have typed it in, but I'm just showing you that you can do a tag search here. And then I can choose to either when the expression is evaluated or the timestamp of the triggering event. So I want to timestamp my performance equation when I evaluate the expression. And you'll notice that if you use event-based scheduling, it does put that in the event tag field in your equation tab. So I've got the scheduling I wanted to use. Every time CDT 158 gets a value, I'm going to evaluate this expression. And if it's greater than 80, then I want my batch to start. And it works out very well that it's going to report a 0 or a 1, true or false. Remember, we talked earlier about the compression and exception. In this case, I don't want to miss any of my threshold events, so I'm going to set my deviation to 0 for exception and compression because I want to make sure I keep all of the results from my expression and equation tag. So I'll save this, and now this tag can be used to generate certain values for my triggers. I'd like to look at the previous example that we used, but throw a little bit more complexity into it because I think that'll reflect more real-life situations. Let's say I want to compare my CDT 158 tag to my ambient temperature of 80 degrees, but I want to make sure that that temperature has been exceeded for more than 2 minutes because I don't want little spikes in the ambient temperature to start a new batch. So I want to make sure that that value is greater than that for more than 2 minutes before I start my batch. So I'm going to go in and create a performance equation tag. I'm going to call this trigger 2. Oops. And what I need to, it's going to be an integer again. And what I need to do is create an equation using my performance equation engine. And if I look in the program files, PyPC, and help folder, what I'll find is a folder called pereference.chm. That's the help file to the performance equation syntax. And if I open that up, what I'll find is a complete reference to all the performance equation functions and their syntaxes and operators, all described here in detail. I want to use the time greater than function, and I want to see or detect when that tag is greater than that certain value. So I'm gonna do a little copying here. I'm gonna copy the format of the syntax out of the performance equation manual, and I'm gonna paste it into the equation field. Now I've got to do some alterations here. I have to change the tag name to CDT 158. Pay close attention that I did use single quotes. Remember, it's single quotes for tag names and timestamps. So my start time is going to be single quote asterisk minus 2m. That's going to go back 2 minutes every time I do the calculation. And my end time is going to be a now symbol, an asterisk. And the value is going to be 80. So I'm comparing the tag name over the last 2 minutes. Whenever I evaluate this, I'm going back 2 minutes, I'm comparing it and finding out how many seconds the value was over 80. And if I evaluate it, you'll see that it returns a number of seconds. So I need to further adjust this equation to make my result either a 0 or 1, because I want this to be a trigger. I don't want to have something else evaluate whether, you know, 120 is a good number or whether 92 is a good number. So I'm going to change my expression. I'm going to add a little bit to it, and I'm going to say if this expression, and I'll put parentheses around the whole expression, if that expression is greater than 120, then we have a value of 1, else we have a value of 0. I could have also used else no output, but I'm going to use else 0. I'm going to evaluate that, and I can see that I do have a 0 here. So the expression, it's not greater than 120. It's there's a little bit of a problem there, because it'll never be greater than 120 because I'm going back 120 seconds and it's reporting the value in seconds. So why don't we say, if I want to do this this correctly, why don't we say 119, and that will evaluate properly. That way, when we exceed 119 seconds, we will report a value of 1, else 0. And of course, we have the same scheduling aspects that we want. We can either do it based on clock or event, and we want to make sure that we adjust our exception and compression statistics to be appropriate for our trigger tag. So there's an example of something a little bit more complex. Also notice that when I review this tag, it puts the equation in the extended descriptor field. You can build these tags. You can build these tags with Point Builder. You just have to remember that instead of having the equation tab, what you get is you get the extended descriptor field, and you have to put the expression in the extended descriptor field instead of using the equation tab. It's nice to use the performance equation builder because you get the equation tab with the evaluate button, and you can see if you've made any sort of mistake or not.